much my hands. Kevin Monko. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Kevin Monko.
I just want to give you a piece of advice, first of all. An animal makes a terrible gift, okay? I've been given an animal as a gift twice in my life. When I was a kid, my dad came home from a bar with a baby goose. I was about nine. I think he had been drinking, and somebody came into the bar with a box of baby geese. He bought one, he brought it home for me, and it was actually great. I loved it. It followed me around the neighborhood and actually made for a nice pet. But it outgrew our apartment. Geese, you don't really think of geese as being large animals until you have to share a bed with one. So ultimately, we put a friend of ours took it. He had a nice pen behind the house. He raised the goose for us. At some point, a couple years later, my dad had remarried, despite the fact that he told me, you know, I said, hey, you're spending a lot of time with this woman, Tess. Are you thinking about getting married again? And he said, Kevin, I never want to be that happy again. So I took that advice as well. But they invited me over for Christmas dinner, and at the end of dinner, they informed me that we had eaten my goose. So that was a little awkward for me. But this isn't a story about a goose. This is actually a story about a cat. I had a girlfriend in college who had a cat, and she got a new roommate who was allergic to cats. And so she gave me the cat as a gift, and I said I couldn't really decline it because girlfriends were hard for me to come by at that time. So I accepted the cat, knowing that it was an unwelcome addition to our house, because I lived with four guys. We had agreed we weren't supposed to have any cats. We had convinced the landlord to let us have one because one of my roommates had a cat when we were moving in. It was a deal breaker. He didn't want to get rid of the cat. So the landlord, Mike, said, you can have one cat, which we turned into two cats, convincing him that if you have two cats, they play with each other, and they're not going to make a mess, they don't get into things, they need a playmate. So he said, okay, two cats, two, that's it. Any more cats, you're evicted. Now, he never really came around, so I figured three cats we'll get away with. But what I didn't realize was that the cat was pregnant. So, and then in the meantime, which really came as a surprise, by the way, because Larry, the cat, was, as it turns out, Larry was actually a hermaphrodite, presumably, I guess gay. I mean, he was impregnated by another male cat, you know, but in any case, and then one of our other cats got pregnant, and they had litters of kittens, like, days apart. So one morning I wake up and I hear a voice in the kitchen invoking the name of Jesus Christ over and over again, and the voice was unfamiliar, or I didn't recognize the voice. I ran down to the kitchen, and there was Mike, the landlord, in the middle of the kitchen, surrounded by a dozen cats, all pawing at him, and they hadn't been fed, and they were meowing and pawing, and he looked me right in the eye, and I'll never forget what he said. He looked me right in the eye, and he said, Jesus Christ, fucking cats. They were his words. So, and at this point, I had, I think, the best idea I've ever had in my life, which was, the best idea I ever had was the time I didn't pick a fight with Mitch Williams on a plane. You know Mitch Williams? Wild Thing? In any case. But I remember, we had a roommate at the time who was in medical school in Mexico, and he would drive back and forth to take tests, and in one of these trips, he had brought back a cat cadaver and that he kept, allegedly, I hadn't seen it, but it was supposedly in the back of the basement in a cooler in a plastic bag soaking in formaldehyde. So I said, Mike, I have to show you something. So we go down to the basement, I look for the cooler. Sure enough, there's the cooler. I open the cooler, I open the bag, there's a cat cadaver. It was very freaky. And I said, Mike, I have to show you this. Come over here and take a look. And I opened the bag, and he looked at it, and he backed up to the wall. He's freaked out. Said, Jesus Christ, a couple more times. And at that point, I looked at him in the eye, and I said, Mike, here's the point. The cats aren't going to be here that long. You know, Bruce is in medical school, and he's going to, there's things he has to do. And he said, okay, I get it. And I said, and his reaction was very interesting, because he just said, how long? And I said, well, end of the summer, tops. He said, okay, as long as they're gone by the end of the summer. He was cool with that. And he just stalked up the stairs, and just before the door slammed, I heard him say, Jesus Christ, fucking cats. That's what he said.